Hello, we are at the WordPress backend that is using the Elementor Pro plugin. Today, I am going to clarify all the tabs that is related to page for Elementor Pro. So under Team Builder, you see the single page tab. Under Saved Templates, you also see a page tab. And well, at the WordPress panel, you see Pages tab as well. So what do they do individually and how do they relate to each other? Let's start working on it. Now let's get back to Theme Builder and let's click on this single page. So when we create a single page under Theme Builder, we are actually creating just a layout. This layout is how we want our content to be portrayed, okay, to look like when we create new pages later under here, all right? So our content is not going to look just boring, maybe just a page, a normal title and a normal content box. But it will look the way we design it to be under this single page tab. So let's try. Okay, so let's just create this informational pages template where we do want to use this template for all information pages. Now, let's not take from the library here, cross it out and then add a session. I did it to full width and stretch. Now go back to the element here. I will pull this post title over to this row here. So this post title is not really hello world in the front end. It will be whatever the page title is. So if you create a new page called About Us, then you see About Us here. Now, how do you want that About Us to show up here? Probably you want to centralize it. We shall add a bit of a style, a bit of a background to the section. Okay, say a darker gray here and then hover effect. And then perhaps a lighter gray upon hover. Let's also add a little bit of padding. Good. Okay, now let's get back to the elements list. Okay, so this is the elements list for the single page, and you see the single elements here is really exclusively here for the single page. Now for every single page layout that we design, we have to, it's compulsory to put in this post content, because if we don't, it creates error when we try to create a new page, because there's no space, no container for us to put and design our content. So let's do something a little bit more, say, drastic. Let us actually just add a two column, all right, a two column, and then I'm going to drag this post content element into this left side, all right, so that okay, and then I'm just going to cross out this part. Now I want all my content to just appear here, all right. I want to centralize it here. I also want to add a little bit of padding and make it more obvious. Go to border and include a box shadow here. Okay, so this is how I actually want my content to appear when I put in content into my new page. So let's get back to the elements editor. Okay, so these are queried. Okay, these elements, when we pull in, they query out the content when we create a new page. Whereas these elements below are fixed. They are fixed contents. So let's just try to drag this button over here. And maybe this button says something like buy now. All right. Buy now. And then it goes to the extreme right, and it is extra large. And the link, I'll just leave it without a link, all right, okay. So just to show that this button, buy now button, will just show up for every single page that I assign this layout to. So let's watch later. Okay, so let's publish this thing. We now need to add condition. I'm going to include all pages and then I need to exclude some pages. Okay, I need to exclude the homepage. Okay, because I do not want this homepage to adopt that layout for obvious reasons. I want it to retain its original design. All right, so I'm going to exclude this from the layout home. I am also going to exclude another page, which is the showroom page. We call it the showroom page here. We do not want this page to adopt that layout that we just built. So I'm excluding it and showroom. So every other pages, I'm okay with it adopting this layout. So it's updated here. Let's leave this place and go back to the create pages in WordPress. So we add new. So for example, I can just use about us as a title, and then when I edit with Elementor, I may now drag and drop only my content here because I assigned this to be the post content box. I am unable to drag anything anywhere else because I did not assign any post content there. All right, so wherever I assign a post content, I may put in whatever I want here. Okay, so I shall put in a text editor and I shall put in some content. I will just say we sell furniture from all over the world. And I shall publish this thing and have a look. So now for every single page I built, the content will appear here. Okay, because I set it this way in the theme builder, and the buy now button will be here, and the post title will be here, and it will be queried from the post title that I put when I add in the new page. Okay, so let's just do a little bit of recap, get out of here. Now, these pages here will create the information, the content pages, but you may or may not want to design the layout from here, especially if it is duplicate layout. Like for informational pages, you may want it to be a duplicate layout. And when you want to have duplicate layout, that's where this theme builder single page helps, because it will create a layout that you may just use for every single page. And you may exclude whichever page you do not want to adopt that layout. You may also create many different layouts for many different kinds of pages and just add condition. Now, what is then the difference between this single page and saved templates? You see a page tab here. Okay, so what is the difference? Let's click on all. So when you see all, you see a single page template. We do have some single page templates, and you will see a page template. The difference between the single page template and a page template is that the page template is whatever you design on this page template, it is what it is. There is no querying. Whereas for single page templates, we do query the post title, we query the post content, and then we have it that layout to be used for different kind of post content. But when we use a page template, we will not have different kinds of content. We'll just have one kind. So let's just put in one kind as the template name. We hardly use this page template, so but it's just to show you how it works and how it interacts with the WordPress pages. But I have not thought, okay, of any reason for us to use these page templates, all right? So if you see this title over here and you find it very ugly, you may just exit to dashboard. You may move down here under post attributes template, you change it to Elementor full width. And then of course you publish it first to save it. And then you go into edit with Elementor and it will be gone. So it works the same way as every other pages if you do not want to see the ugly title over there. Now, we can just do whatever we want. You realize that at this panel, you do not see the single elements. You don't see any attempts for querying. So you only see the normal editing elements. So let's just drag this heading over here. Say just for fun. Okay, just for fun. And then we add the text editor over here. Okay, let's see what happens. Okay, and then we just update it. So we've created a just for fun template. Okay, create a just for fun template. And then let us try to create a new page. Okay, try to create a new page. So to adopt this, okay? So this is page for fun, perhaps, all right? And then when you edit with Elementor, what you see here will be the layout that you design under theme, the theme builder. But if you go to this folder here and you extract the page template that you created earlier, one kind template, you insert it, yes, it will just override whatever you design under your theme builder as a page template. So this is just a page template. Okay, so well, you may just add whatever you want below, but it actually works the same way as a theme builder single page, right? So I don't really see a need for us to use this page template. I feel that the theme builder single page template is much more useful. So let's not confuse ourselves, and perhaps we can just leave it, and we don't have to use this page template. Okay, so let's exit to dashboard. So I hope I'm clear about the difference among the three different page tabs that you see. Okay, two of them in Elementor. So for Elementor Pro, just stick to theme builder and just stick to single page for layout, and then create the pages contents under here. Okay, so hope this helps. That is all. Thank you for watching.